Welcome everyone. So my name is Kunis Kumro and I am going to demonstrate FESM, that is field emission scanning electron microscope, and I am going to demonstrate how it works and how we can characterize our sample through the FESM.
The field emission scanning electron microscope is named because the electrons are generated from a tungsten tip which stays in the vicinity of an electric field. After a certain voltage, the tip liberates electrons which travels through the electromagnetic coil to be focused on the substrate. After falling on the sample as an incident beam, the diameter of the beam may be as small as 1 nanometer. Once the incident beam hits the sample, mainly three types of electrons are liberated from the sample itself. First one is the secondary electron, then backscatter electron, then the X-ray electron. Secondary electron, which provides fine structure topographical feature of sample's face, and the backscatter electron to discriminate areas of different atomic number element. X-ray electrons are used to identify the composition in measure the amount of the elements in the samples. All kinds of sample topography can be characterized except liquid and magnetic samples. Sometimes biological samples are also challenging. So the magnification that can go from 25x to 10 lakh x, accelerating voltage that can be maintained within 0.5 kV to 30 kV. The probe current also is maintained in between a few picoampere to 200 nanoampere. The image resolution is as high as 1.3 nanometer at 1 kV or 1 nanometer at 15 kV during the analysis. There is a gentle beam inbuilt characterization technique which allows us to characterize soft materials without destroying much of the sample, and that incident beam does not penetrate in that much so that the sample will not burn.
So there are certain main components are here, like this column where the electrons are generated, in the specimen chamber where we can keep our sample inside here, then the vacuum pump, then the monitor and the controller. So these are the main components over here.
So today our sample is a small piece of butterfly wings. So this sample we are going to look at through the FESM. So I have the sample holder and the carbon tape is pasted on it, and I'll put that sample on the carbon tape. So now comes the next part. As this sample, it is non-conductive, so we have to make it a little bit conductive, so using the sputter coater. So we will coat the platinum on this non-metallic surface. So this one is our sputter coater. So you see, this is the chamber where we will put our sample. So once we close the lid, so it will get vacuum. We will switch on this instrument. So there are certain parameters, those are current and pressure and the time also. So according to our requirement, the thickness of the deposited platinum, we have to set the time as well as the current. So generally we use here 20 milliampere, and the time that in second we generally use around 90 to 120 second. After reaching a certain pressure, that is around 2.9, then we will start the deposition of the platinum on the sample. So that pressure has come to the 2.9, so we can start the deposition of platinum on the sample now.
So now I am going to put our sample, that is the butterfly wings, inside the specimen chamber. So before that we have to vent the instrument, because the whole system that has to be in the vacuum inside. So once this specimen chamber, it comes to the ambient pressure, then we can open this lid.
Once we keep our sample, then we again have to vacuum the whole chamber along with the specimen chamber. So once the specimen chamber's pressure, it comes to the near to the inside chamber, then only we can insert our sample from this specimen chamber to the inside. So while the inside pressure is reducing when the pump is working, in the meantime we can set our voltage. We may start with the 5 kilovolt, that I am doing gradually decreasing. It was initially 15, then 10, then I set it at 5, and the other parameter, emission current, that is already automated with the according to the acceleration voltage, and the probe current is also maintained at 6. So this schematic, it is showing the whole instrument. I mean the FESM, that column you can see here, and this is the specimen chamber. So this is now the color, it is gray color, and the whole system is gray color. That means it is showing the inside pressure, it is all over same. And we can now insert our sample inside the FESM.
So as now the pressure has come to our requirement, so we can insert our sample from the specimen chamber to inside the FESM. Once the sample is inserted, so we can see this dialog box where it is asking the specimen holder that we are using here. So this one we have used, so we can select it, and the offset we have to give, and the offset, that means the thickness of the sample, and in this case we are using the butterfly wings. It has much less thickness, so we don't require to give any thickness parameter. But unless if we are using glass slide or other any thick material, then in that case we have to give the thickness of the sample. So now I am going to take the stage little bit upward. So this one is the objective that we call, and this is the specimen that we have,
and the specimen holder also. So we need to make it little bit closer to the objective. So in that case, we have to reduce the working distance. So you may see that substrate holder, it is getting closer to the objective. It is not required all the time that we need to keep the substrate holder too close to the objective. So in this instrument, we maintain around the pressure that is less than 10 to the power minus 4, and once it the pressure inside the chamber it goes beyond 10 to the power minus 4, then only we can start the electron gun. So it has gone already, so we can start here. So this is a very fine instrument. So what you are looking at right now, it is the butterfly wings, and it has some pattern structure, that is some scales which are patterned. So with the controller, I can rotate the sample holder. I can make it move XY direction. I can make it tilted also in different angle. I can get zoomer and zoomer to get fine view of the smallest structure on the sample. So now we are basically detecting the secondary electron that is coming from the just top surface itself. Sometimes it is called as the primary electron. So you may see these are the scales which are patterned, and we may go more zoomer. So with this FESEM, we can go up to 10 nanometer scale. So right now we are at 10 micrometer, so that is at 750x, but it is possible to characterize in around 10 nanometer scale. So I am doing a little bit zoomer on a particular scale, so you may see some fine microstructure on the scale. That is very fascinating. So there is a whole new world in microscopic scale that is beyond our sight.